I was searching for CAD programs on Linux, and that's in my pub shop. I was searching for CAD programs, and I typed CAD, and I encountered this Space Cadet pinball, which I used to play on Windows. I went there, I installed it, it's a flat tub. And as it was installing, I noticed the screenshots. The first one is very similar to what I know, to what I used on Windows. After all, it says that this is a reverse engineering product of 3D pinball for Windows, and it's by Andrei Muzichenko. I don't know if I pronounced the name correctly, sorry if I didn't. And looking at the second screenshot, the part here, the Space Cadet, is a bit different. It's not what I'm used to seeing, but this part here seems more clear. So if we compare the two screenshots, this one is pixelated, granulated. This one seems more clear, so I expect this to scale better. I previously played another game on Linux, another pinball game on Linux. It's called Problem Up, and it has nice graphics, but its problem is that it's an abandoned project, so if I maximize it, that's what happens. It won't maximize. Now back to the game that we just installed. I expected it to scale somehow better than what it does on Windows, but if we look at the graphics, these are the graphics. The resolution is 640 times 480. It's not different. Before proceeding with playing the game, I went to its about and help about, and you can see its source code here in the GitHub page. And let's start playing. So has the same sounds that the original game had. I guess the MP3 files are there as well. And we can activate the music. It's the same track that I already knew. Back in the days of Windows XP, I used to play this on Windows XP. So let's start it. It seems to work fine. I can't see glitches yet. That's a redeploy. There's a tension to the reverse engineering that's been made. We can also see that it saves the high scores. So if we go to game and we can see the high scores here, it's not in the Windows fashion, that's predictable, but, and it starts from zero. That's interesting. Now, I also noticed some cheats here. So to start first, there's one max, and with one max you'll get an extra ball, so you can keep getting extra balls. That's because I clicked one max, I got another one right now. Another cheat that we have is the G-Max. The G-Max would activate the gravity well, so as it passes in this zone, it would be attracted to the blinking point here. You can see the ball isn't acting naturally. This is not ticked anymore since we lost the ball. Let's try it again. So again, near this blinking point, we should expect the ball to behave differently, and that's again the gravity well activated. The ball is somehow being deflected from its trajectory. So let's keep playing. Let's try another cheat, and we have the R max. The R max gives us a promotion. So again, cheats, R max, we are promoted to captain. And we also have the B max. Now the B max, I didn't figure out what it does on my own. I went into this site, and we can see that it's never lose. So if you activate the BMAX, you won't lose the game, but to be fair, you won't get a high score. And that makes sense. Now, the most interesting cheat is the hidden test, and the hidden test allows you to drag the ball with your mouse. So that's the ball, and I'm gonna grab it and place it where I want. And for example, this is activating the buttons, it's hitting, it's not only dragging it, it's doing what the ball does when it hits certain points. So if you ever wondered what some spots did but you couldn't reach them, that's your chance to try them. Also, you have to follow the natural trajectories. Like, I can't take the ball and put it at different points without following the path that the ball should take. Like, I can't put this ball in the purple zone. I need to let it enter from this point, and from there it would enter the purple zone. That's very interesting, and that's a nice cheat to have. At the end, this is a game that brings back some nostalgia, and it's nice that it's available on different platforms. You see, it's on Windows, on Linux, on Mac, and it has some nice touches, the cheats, and it allows one to explore. I really appreciate what the developer did here.